Yo, what is going on, guys? Senkai here, and in today's video I'm going to be teaching you guys how to get any tailed beast you want. And for this video we'll be basically talking about a method or a few methods on how you can get them even as a beginner. Like if you want to get your first tailed beast, basically we're going to teach you how to use it, just getting flame and a bloodline that I will tell you guys, like you at least need to spin for something. But we'll basically go on like a full overview, so this will be a pretty long video on how to get it. I will show me, like, you know, killing the tailed beast as well with it, and you know, it's all about that mindset. But this place will be divided into sections to help you guys out, basically. So I'll be going through an overview on what you guys need to focus on, stuff you need to do, how it makes it easier for you, how you can find a tailed beast in your server, and how to kill it, obviously. But before I do start this video, I would like to say, if you guys are new to this channel, my name is Senkai, and help me reach 25k by the end of, you know, the month. So we just need like 4k more, or like, you know, 3k. So if you are new, make sure you guys subscribe, like with this video, and join my Discord server down below in the description if this helps you. Oh, and yeah, if you guys do have any questions or need any help, not by, like, you know, I can't help you guys, you know, get it myself, but I will help you on like what you guys need to do and all that to get it yourself. So I will basically help you throughout, like if you need, like, you know, tips on how to like kill it, any good bloodlines you need to kill it, or any sub-jutsus you need to kill it, then I will basically teach you. But yeah, I will basically teach you in this video, like, the basics on how to kill it. Like, you just need like a fire element. You need like an element if you, like, you know, you don't have any good bloodlines or anything. I will teach you guys if you have good bloodlines, if you don't have good bloodlines, if you have sub-jutsus, if you don't have sub-jutsus. I will teach you everything that you need to know in this video, and I will be spending my time and, you know, thought processes to teach you guys. So make sure you guys subscribe, hit that like button, and join my Discord server down below in the description. Without further ado, let's just get straight into it, and we'll head on to the first section. All right, guys, and the first section we have is basically leveling up. In order to defeat a tailed beast, obviously you need to be level 400 or 600, around that, to unlock it. So what I recommend people to do if they are like a starter to this game, so they're like F0, is to hit the logs, do missions until you're level 1000. Because once you're level 1000, you're able to put points into stats, which obviously boosts up your stats. So your HP, your chakra, your stamina, and your mode. Your mode is what really helps you a lot, because it does a boost on those things as well. And we'll get into what bloodline you need to use later on. But basically, you know, if you are, you know, new to the game, I recommend you guys obviously upgrading chi, nin, health, and tai. So focus on maxing out these two first before you max out tai, because obviously when you're fighting a tailed beast, you're not going to m1 it, you know, obviously. But the best way to level up yourself is doing these green scroll missions with friends, you know, being a squad, have one accepted, have one to do it, or doing those red scroll missions with our bosses. There's one over there, as you can see him, and there's one all the way on that building over there as well. These help you guys basically level up. You can use stats, and they just boost your damage that you do for, like, you know, flame jutsus and all that, anything. It just boosts the overall damage, and that's like the first priority that you want to get straight. Obviously, you know, leveling up is the best thing you can do in this game. You get stronger, and you can obviously, you know, beat them. But if you guys don't want to be level 1000, I feel like level 800 is like the bare minimum for, you know, obviously attacking a tailed beast, because these guys do a ton of damage, and it's really hard for you to, you know, kill them if you're not high level, because your stats aren't fully leveled up. These things won't do as much damage as, you know, you plan them for them to be. And I just feel like being level 1000 is the key step into killing these tailed beasts. So it's way easier for you, you won't take as much time, and just overall easy. But basically, yeah, first step, guys, get a level 1000 or 800 if you're lazy. But trust me, guys, being a level 1000, even at like rank F0, you won't be able to get 6000 like this. I think it's like at 5200 or 5400, but still, it is enough to help you a lot, and it just overall boosts your damage. And that's literally the first step you need to do. Do green scroll missions. If not, then do boss missions with your choice. If you want, you can do it with friends. And another choice you can do with leveling up is you can go over to the, you know, this is the old Embers village, but you can go ahead and talk to the first Hokage, which is Hashirama, and you can rank up. It's overall your choice, but yet again, you have to grind again to obviously get back to level 1000. But if you do rank up, you will be able to basically, you know, get more stat points. So if it was like 5,200 at F0, you go to D1, I'm pretty sure, and it upgrades to 5,400 max, and you just get more points. So that's something you can choose. If not, like I said, just stay up F0. You can still get a tailed beast at F0, and it's overall really, really easy, guys. But that was basically the first, you know, section that we had leveling up, and we're gonna go ahead and move on to the next section, which is a moveset that you guys want to basically use. And this will be divided into two parts, basically for very new beginners that only have an element and they spun a few times. You know, maybe you're lucky enough to get a really good bloodline, and maybe you're, you know, unlucky enough to get a decent bloodline or a bad bloodline. But we're gonna basically talk about that, and I'm gonna help you guys on that. So this next section will be really, really informational. So if you are new to this channel, and you know, new to Shindo, make sure just like, you know, listen up a bit, because I will explain it thoroughly. All right, guys, so another key stepping stone is having at least a good mode, which is this C spec. And what's the C spec? It basically drains your mode. It gives you, obviously, you know, a boost on the right side for stat boost. But one thing that I really recommend you guys is, as if you have flame, like flame is like the overall best element in my opinion. That's like the you know, easiest to get, the 1 out of 5 ones to kill a tailed beast, because it does a lot of damage just to hit it right. So like this section will be basically for the new beginners. If you guys want to get a tailed beast like really fast and you just started the game, get flame maxed out and you're good. And then what you want to do is, after you have flame, the remaining spins that you have, you can try spinning a bloodline that can get. It's a Z-spec move, as long as a mode, and it gives you a stat boost. So as you can see here on the right side, look at that, it gives you 2500 chi, 2200 nin, 2400 tai, and 1800 health. This is enough, guys. This is literally enough and all you need in order to you know, kill a tailed beast. Because obviously, look, this one, 24,000 damage without mode, and I'm pretty sure if I remember it did 18,000, so you have a free 8,000 damage with that. And you also have the Z-spec move, and then actually helps you a lot, and literally flame is all you need. And we're gonna go ahead and move on to another section where it makes it a bit easier for you guys. So let's get straight into that, and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna change. And as you can see, guys, in the bottom left of our move set, we have changed two moves, and those two moves were the first two moves of the flame, and we changed it with Super Odama Spirit Bomb and Spirit Bomb Shuriken Rush. Now the reason we changed it is because these two sub-jutsus are really, really easy to get, really, really like one's a 1 out of 10 and one's a 1 out of 12, I'm pretty sure. And you can get this one in Ember and this one in the Forest of Embers. And I'll be teaching you guys how to get those sub-jutsus basically in the next section after the pro version of, I guess. But these really do help a lot. If you're in mode, let's say you're back in Senko mode, I guess, or even a better mode. Look, you click H, or my bad, not H, you click R, which is the thing. And boom, there you go. 100,000 damage is the area. And then this one does do 60,000 damage. So it's just like an overall boost. Like I said, if you want to make it easier for you, really easy to get. All you have to do is get preset codes in the server and then you know, hop for it. But I will teach you guys more about that in a bit. But that's basically like these two moves are really, really good on helping you. And it's really easy to kill a tail beast with that. Honestly, just the best thing you can do is just get that those two. Not even that, it's not even hard to get it. You have to have the courage, and you know, the obviously you gotta have the, you know, the motivation to hop for it. But that's basically, you know, the section mode where for beginners, guys, it's for all beginners, you know. Don't worry about the pro section. If you guys are still pro, you have decent amount of bloodlines, and you still, you know, you have sub-jutsus, then I will teach you a moveset as well. But let's go ahead and move on to that section right now. Now, a decent setup that I'd see like most probably like, let's say, D3s, C1, C2s, which people that still don't have a bloodline or still don't have a tailed beast, they would probably, obviously, if they were smart enough during your time, was to get Super Odama. Yes, sir. So this is for people that, you know, have played the game for a bit. Obviously, Super Odama is a need if you played a bit, played the game a bit. Spirit Bomb, you know, Rush. Spirit Shuriken Rush is a need, and usually I'm pretty sure they spin for Gale, which is really, it's a really good element. It does tons of damage, and it piles up over time. And at this point, you can still use Flame. Like, that's how good Flame is, guys. It just does tons of damage, and overall, it's like range, so it does a ton of damage. And I do expect people who play the game for a bit to have at least an Akuma. Or like something that's like 1 in 100, so it can be, you know, Rakken Shizen, it can be Arake Jokai, Shiver Akuma, Ashen Storm, Dio Senko, Rian Akuma, any of the good Akumas. It can be the God Bloodlines. Just, I feel like at least they'd have one after spinning for so long and being in the game so long. But not having a tailed beast, honestly, bro, if you had an Akuma, Akumas are really good for killing tailed beasts, because it's like, you know, Uchiha, it's like, you know, Sasuke and Naruto basically. But I feel like it is the best way to kill a tailed beast, because obviously you have a Susanoo, which does a lot of damage. And if you did play war mode and you killed your true spirit form, you would be able to get your full Susanoo basically. And this one does a lot of damage to tailed beast, because all you can do is run away, left click, and then you also have your RMB C spec, which is, you know, takes your mode. Just, I don't even know if that's good for tailed beast, but it's still good. You know, Q spec just dashes at them. You have your moves for them. This is auto dodge, so if the tailed beast hits you, then you auto dodge them. This is copy stop pain. I'm pretty sure you can hit it on a tailed beast, but it doesn't really affect them as much. And they have a Amaterasu for Itachi's manga kill. But I'm saying, guys, nonetheless, these modes will really help you a lot. You just have to have that PvP common sense, you know. It's really, really good. If you know how to fight, if you know when to back off, you know when to use your health stim, you know, oh my gosh, I'm low, I'm gonna stay for a bit, and then you should be good. But this is basically the section that we're gonna end off of, your moveset. And now we're gonna be talking about basically how you can find a tailed beast, aka how you can server hop. And this does apply to what I said before about finding these moves, you know, Super Dama Spirit Bomb and Shuriken Rush. So stay tuned, guys. Don't worry, it'll be a quick example, quick thing, and let's get straight into it. All right, guys, and obviously the first method we have is buying the private server game pass. But who has 1,000 Robux laying around nowadays? So you can basically scratch this one. If you have it, then you're lucky. I have it, but you know, we're trying to teach some new people how to get tailed beasts. Obviously they won't spend Robux on the game easily, but what you want to do is I'm gonna head and leave a document in the description. And there are tons of codes on that document, and I'll show you guys on screen right now. Basically, you can use any of those codes to hop, and there's a lot of them. So you can like shuffle through servers if you want. You can go ahead and, you know, I mean, if you don't know how to travel to the private server, all you have to do is click M, travel, go to this private server thing, click it, and then input the code. You can copy and paste it, and once you pasted it, it'll be a six, you know, thing. 6-digit code, so it can be like that. You know, even the underscore counts as a digit, so it can be like that, and you just spam teleport, and then you will be in the server. And if you do not find what you're looking for, then obviously you can still hop for a different server. You can go into multiple different servers. And a real cool thing that guys, if you're really hopping and there's only like 5 private server codes, you can shuffle through all those 5 private server codes and you'll still be able to find it, because the server resets once the last person leaves. So if you go into 2, you can do 2, like you can transition between 2 servers and try and find what you're looking for, and if you're lucky enough you will find it. But it does work because the server, like I said, does reset after you are done. But that's basically how you can find tailed beast, sub-jutsus, and all that, because, you know, obviously, you know, we want to find tailed beast in this scenario. So like I said, guys, doing that will help you guys easily if you don't have the private server game pass. And if you guys that document that I'm just gonna show you guys, it is kind of being used by a lot of people. So if you guys want, I do have a ton of codes in my Discord server. So if you guys, like, you know, if you want to join my Discord server and take those codes, then that is entirely up to you guys. If you want to use them, that is entirely up to you guys. They are there for you guys. That is a really good reason, or a really good thing to do as well in my Discord server, because there's tons of codes that will help you guys find your jin / tailed beast. And yeah, this is basically the end of the section, guys. You know, just a quick overview on how you can do it, how you can find other you know, servers, how you can find private servers and use them. And then the next one we're going to be going into is attacking the tailed beast, and I'll be splitting this 2 sections as well. I will be attacking using the basic, you know, fire elements, you know, R, T, Y, and then G, or F, my bad, and then G, and then H, and I'll be using a decent bloodline. I'm probably gonna be using Senko, but you know, hey man, it's whatever, you know. It is Z-spec, so I will be probably using Senko, you know, something that it can be different for you guys, but flame is basically all you need. And yeah, we're gonna go ahead and find tailed beast now. This works for any tailed beast, guys. You guys have to have some common sense, basically. So let's go ahead and move on to that section. Alright, guys, so for hopping, you want to know which tailed beast you're gonna get, and the second it turns the time on when they spawn, you want to go ahead and hop. And it's best if you hop like 30 seconds after, because to load in it takes 30 seconds, so time is very crucial when hopping for it. So if you want, you can go and hop already now and just wait in there, because like I said, time is crucial and you need as much time as you want in order to kill the tailed beast, especially since you're rocking flame only, you know. So obviously, you know, just going to a haze right now, you can, I guess, wait a bit, and then once you do find it, obviously you just gotta wait. But I think my thing's broken, bro. No, I gotta restart. Oh my gosh. But yeah, like I was saying, guys, you want to know when your tailed beast spawns, and you basically want to go to that village before it does spawn, so you have a higher chance. You know, you may find it in that server because it's a 1 out of 10 chance to spawn. And if you do find it, then obviously I will teach you basically how to do it right now. So you basically want to be good at PvP and all that. So right now I'm going to haze because I want to find Isu Tailed Spirit, and I'm just gonna go ahead and time lapse this until I find it. But if I find it in this server, then I'll just stop it. But yeah, basically just find it. Once you find it, search on YouTube where it spawns and instantly go to that location. So we're just gonna find it real quick, and hopefully, you know, we find it in this server or in a bit one. Finally, there you go, guys. Okay, so I'm gonna make it really quick for you guys. Let's just say that you guys did get Super Adama, which I really hope you guys all did, because it's really good. It is worth it. It does tons of damage. Let me go straight in there. And right now, I only have 10 minutes to do so. 10 minutes, so, or 9 actually right now. So I'm gonna go there as fast as I can. See how much damage I can do in 9 minutes using just Super Adama, Flame, and Senko. I may be able to do more damage or less depending on what bloodline you guys have, but any bloodline works, like I said. So let me go there real quick, please. Safe spawns all the way over here, so let me just go there real quick, and then yeah. Oh my bad, this is Isu. Isu spawns right here. I went to the wrong location. I'm wasting time, guys. I am wasting time so much. He's right. He's gonna be right here. I think so. I'm pretty sure you should be right here. Yeah, there he is. Okay, so I'm wasting mode right now. I'm gonna just quickly get my mode. But what you want to do is basically utilize the range attack for you know, obviously for flame. So you can just use all your flames that are, you know, that are ranged. It's way more damage with, you know, obviously that. But let me just quickly change it for F, because I want as much range as possible, right? So there we go. Let me go into mode real quick. And like I said, guys, if you go into mode, it does tons of damage. And your Super Adama Spirit Bomb, bro, I feel like it's a must-have. It's really easy to get using this. So go ahead and just use it real quick. Boom. That's all you need. It does like 100k damage. This one, come on. Use everything here. Everything here matters right now. Just keep using it. Look at that. He's not chasing me so far. I should be good. You could use moves like that. Like that. And then just keep any move matters, guys. Like already 400,000 damage in like less than a minute. But now that's following me, this will be pretty hard to defeat. But all you have to do is basically run away. Its roar is the only thing that basically matters. Like, you can go up here. You can just utilize the environment around you, basically. Like, you have to have some common sense. Every time Super Dama comes back, guys, use it. Trust me. Literally all you have to do. And this guy's just going to keep ragdolling me. That's what I hate about this. But don't worry. Just keep, you know, just keep doing that. And I won't have enough time because obviously I'm only using a flame move. So don't worry, guys. Dogged on like this because it is a tailed beast. Obviously you're going against a tailed beast, but try and make some space between you guys, you know. Boom, look at that. And I feel like if I did have enough time, guys, I would be able to do more damage, like I said. Obviously Super Dama Spear Bomb, trust me, guys, you need this. And I'm just gonna go ahead and utilize the environment real quick because he can't go over this. So look at that, guys. Already in less than what, like 2 minutes, I was able to do 800k damage with the addition of Super Dama. You probably do like 600k damage just with flame, but right now this guy's chilling there, so I'm gonna just use that. Bomb. Oh, and then bomb, bomb, and these are missing, but it's fine. Super Dama Spear Bomb yet again. Time stop here. Get out of here. This thing is actually pretty annoying. I don't know. They're different. The tail beasts are different because of the amount of stuff they can do. But come here. If you want to, like I said, if you want to utilize your position, your environment, it's fine. And if you are really low, just like go up here, man. What is he gonna do? And you have a range move, which is flame, right? So all you have to do is leave. Bop. Oh, my bad. And I wasted that, but it's fine. So yeah, all you gotta do is this, basically. You know, pretty cool. But it does get kind of annoying because they do attack simultaneously and it's like range. So nothing much you can do about it. It's literally just range. So if you are low, like I said, you probably have more time than me if you find it early. But just keep going ahead and attack it. You know, right now it's down. When it's down, you have to attack it the most. Like this. There we go. A bit like that. Heal up. Healing up is good. And look at that, he canceled my heal. Sometimes it gets annoying, guys, but don't worry, you will have enough time to kill it if you find it really early. I only have 4 minutes left. See how much damage I can really do. Look at that. Bam, bam, bam. I will die soon, so I'm gonna try and just try and go if I can. And no, I can't. So yeah, you know, using just these basic moves, always expect yourself to die unless you're way better, unless you can utilize your things. If you're against like other tailed spirits, their spawn locations are very different, so it'll be way easier for you. But as you can see already, in less than 5 minutes, I was almost able to do, you know, half its health, and you have 25 minutes to get it. So that's why I'm saying always trying to find it like first is really, really useful and really helpful because it gives you more time to kill it, and it's just really easy, guys. Let me just heal up right now. And that guy, you gotta like aim it right because their hitboxes are really weird. All right, there we go, he's down right now. There we go, and then come here. Bah. And I forgot I am using mode, guys, so whenever you die, I'm pretty sure you don't go back into mode. So let me just real quick go back into mode and we should be good to go. And I was like, that is so, like, the range on that is so annoying, bro. He's just screeching, like, it gets kind of annoying, but don't worry. Go ahead and use that. Bam, bam, bam. Am I glitched? No, I'm not. And holy, I got fly off lung. But here you go. Range moves. Here we go. Range moves. Range moves. Yes, is he stuck? I think he's stuck. Never mind. Never mind. Never mind. There you go. Bam. Bam here. Boom there. Oh, do not Q with the Senko, bro. Not worth it. come here. Damn, that range, bro. I'm telling you, that range. So annoying. Boom. Oh, he canceled it. But look at that. He's almost dead, guys. And I still have 2 minutes left, but I don't think I'm going to make it right now. Maybe. You never know, bro. What if I clutch it up right here, right now? Let's see if I can clutch it up right here, right now. Come here. If these things hit, obviously. Which none of them did. It just depends on where you aim it, guys. It's that flame is it's like the most ranged move, so that's really good about it. Come here, bop, 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 bop. If it does hit, never mind. I don't think it does. I think you have to get closer for it to hit, but nope. Or maybe you have to hit the ground. I'm not sure, but flame is just overall the best for it. Come here. Ah, that's unlucky. Yeah, that's that hit. That hit. It despawns at 9:56, I'm pretty sure. 9:56 because they give you like an extra minute before it despawns, so hopefully I can do as much damage to it as possible. Bomb there. Never mind. Look how annoying it is every time, dude. I actually hate the tails. I understand a lot of people's pain when they do this because, yeah, obviously, you know, takes tons of time to actually kill it. And there I go, I'm dead. I'm probably not gonna, you know, rage from this, but as you can see, I can't even see his health. All I see is his. Anyways, all I see right now is his, but I'm pretty sure his health is really low. It should be at 1 million, but given the fact that I literally came here at like 9:46 EST, that was only 10 minutes, and if you find it really early, guys, it'll be easier for you and way better. So let me just see how much damage I did. So look at that, just a million left, guys. Just a million left. It is really easy to get that. It is going to despawn in 1 minute. So like the method I'm telling you, like super dumb spirit bomb, it does work. It does help. It is worth it. But I'm going to die very soon, or he's going to despawn very soon. I'm just roaring in my face. I don't think I'm gonna do it anytime soon because this thing is annoying, bro. Like I can't do nothing. Like this guy is actually annoying. Like I don't feel like Isu is a really good spirit to go for, but yeah, they're all like this basically. But like I said, man, if you guys, you know, just focus, know how to get out of this. I like every time I try and get out, I can't do nothing obviously because I don't have any moves that help me get out. It can't do nothing, but hopefully I can like check the health a bit one more time. Yeah, as you can see right there, look at that. Pretty decent. It's gonna despawn in 5 seconds. We were able to do like 3.2 million damage, and there you go. So as you can see, he does despawn, and with only 10 minutes, was that? Yeah, 8 minutes, 9 minutes, 10 minutes. I was able to do 3.3 million damage, and they only have 4 million. So you only have a few left, guys. So obviously you know that this method does work. I really, really, really recommend that you guys do get Odama Spirit Bomb. Obviously it's not needed, but it will help you tons, guys. You probably won't be able to die any bloodline race. You probably might even kill it with a different bloodline. If I was probably using Azarashi maybe, or even Minikami, maybe in Bankai for the more experienced people, or even lucky people, I would have won. You never know. It's endless. It just depends on how you can, you know, use the environment for your getaways, run away, use your health pot, use your mode, your Z spec or C spec, even your moves. So it's just based on how good you are at that too, at your common sense basically. So I'm gonna go ahead. That was basically the full guide, guys. We split into sections, and like I said, I wasn't able to kill it. But that's because I only was able to have like 10 minutes of fighting time. And the game does give you 25 minutes. It's 26 minutes if you count the extra minutes. So if you do find it early, lucky for you, you will officially get it. But that's all I have for the video, guys. Hope you guys enjoy. I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. Peace out, guys. Senkai out. And yeah, love you guys no more.